Hey, it's me, the finance guy. Today we're going to be talking about a stock I have my eye on. Give me a like, because you're awesome. Subscribe and hit the bell. I make videos like this all the time. So you might be thinking to yourself, Josh, you're crazy. Molson Coors? Like, are you just speaking gibberish right now? And I just want you guys to hear me out for just 1 second. And maybe you don't like Coors, but let's look at the brands and see if maybe there's something that you like there. Like Blue Moon, did you know that it was owned by Molson Coors? And I think that's really cool because they have a lot of different, like, beers that a lot of people like. Like Hop Valley, this is one that I personally really like. So you have to really take this into consideration when you're doing any kind of investing. Does the company that might be down and out, like, actually have some brands that you personally really like and think that could do successful in the coming year? Only some brands here that people just really don't have the same love for as they had from a long time ago, but I think that Coors in general has a pretty decent amount. And looking at the stock, you can see that it's had a nice little decent run up since the 1990s and forward. I think it's a company that could still do pretty successful, and now we're on a really big dip. And a lot of cannabis has hurt Colorado's beer company because, you know, people are drinking less beer and smoking more weed. But I think you guys should also really think about the long-term prospects of, you know, potentially beer just staying around, especially a domesticated beer like the Coors company. And it has a lot of brand recognition that a lot of people like, especially during the summertime. I think it's like one of those things you go to have like a barbecue and people really like it. And as you can see, the revenue for the company has been really decently somewhat steady. And as time has gone by, towards the tail end, they started to decrease some of their liabilities, which is something I really like in a company, is that they start to pay off some of their debts, especially when we might be moving into a higher interest rate. And that's really exciting to me. And that their cash flow is still pretty decently steady as well. And that's also something that I really like for a company. I really like them to make moves like that that's going to be beneficial for the long term. And I think that Coors might be falling into one of those buying territories where it's starting to get close to what I would view as a bargain buy. And maybe this company can get to a point where they can get back into their, like, you know, beloved status, and that everyone really likes, you know, the Coors beer. And, you know, it really has, you know, had some major swings throughout the years. And I think that domestic beer is maybe on its way out, but I think if they can adapt and they can grow and they can learn from, you know, maybe that microbrews are also going to be really strong and potentially beneficial to making large sums of money in the future, I think that they could do quite well in the beer market, maybe with, you know, eventual legalization of cannabis. Like a beer infused, like, cannabis drink will probably be prevalent in the next 20 years from now. That's very future thinking, but it's just something that you guys should think about when it comes to the future. And maybe you've got some fond memories of the past of something that you did that was a little different. Just like learning how to ride your first bike, you gotta shotgun your first beer. Step one, put a hole in the can. Oh god, there's beer everywhere. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Please subscribe, like, comment down below. I'm really curious to hear your thoughts on Molson Coors and where you think it's going to be going in the future. And I think it's going to do pretty well. We'll see. Thank you so much for watching. See you guys again soon.